understood. All I had to offer him was brokenness and strife, but he made something beautiful of my life. He made something beautiful of my life. Well, it's 11:30 here. I know it's 12:30 in South America. That's why we had that 20 minutes of prayer to accommodate the time there. To whom much is given, much is expected, much is required. So the fact that I have churches in South America, I have to accommodate the brethren there. What a joy it is to be with you again. I'd like to just give you a few insights of 23. And then at 11:45 Canadian time, North American time, we get into the prayer. I'm going to leave the music on in the background. Jesus got a hold of my life and he wouldn't let me go. You've made it. For those in South America, you're already in the new year. Happy New You, Happy New Year. You didn't think you could make it. 2022 was a year filled with everything. Ups and downs like a roller coaster. But we came out more than conquerors through him that loved us. And for those that are happily enjoying 2023, good for you. We aren't there yet. Glory to God. So here we go. I already gave some of these to on the previous services, and this is the third service of the night. To God be the glory. Judgment of the false believers, the false churches, the fake, all the sham, all the grass eating, and the other stuff, can't walk on the floor and all them fake stuff you see happening in the name of church, the Lord is not going to tolerate it. The book says judgment must first begin in the house of God, and if it begins with the saints, where shall the sinner and ungodly appear? But it's coming. And then I said that we are going to have to come to a time, and the time is here, when people must be weaned off milk and spam, and the nice silly sermons, and the seeker-friendly services, to a place where lions roar. We're going to move from the place where cats meow to the place where lions roar. I know you get the analogy, you get what I'm trying to say. The showdown will begin. The showdown has begun. The showdown will begin. And the showdown has begun. God, through his mighty power, will confront evil in all of its forms and in every place that it's hiding. 2023 will be a year of the showdown as believers emerge who are really the remnant and who earnestly contend for the faith. 23 will be the year of the showdown. When you hear me say 23, I'm referring to 2023. Oh yes. We're going to have our scientists scratching their heads because the pace of the earth and time will be speeded up. You know the Bible says, because of iniquity, God will shorten those days. The earth will spin on its axis much faster. Oh yes, watch for that. They'll be scratching their heads wondering what's going on with the earth and its axis. Why is it turning on its axis much faster? Write that one down. Once you can mention things like a showdown, then things are going to speed up. And if it speeds up, that means the earth is going to speed up, literally. As in the natural, so in the spiritual will be something that people will be thinking about. 23 will be the year when God perfects the body in terms of trimming them for the fight, trimming them for the warfare, the spiritual warfare I'm talking about. And there will be teaching that will perfect the body, but primarily the teaching will be to focus on the ability of the believer to fight and to represent the kingdom of God. We're not talking about fistic confrontation. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. We are going to have more skilled soldiers in God's army than ever before. More people with skill. We're talking men, women, and children. Skilled warriors. Because they'll be taught and trained. We're going to see a real move of God. You watch my, mark my word. This is a call to arms. This 2023 will be a year where we are called to arms. Stop playing this little Christianette, smoking cigarette, and listening to sermonette. I said that with a straight face, and then I just had to laugh. Glory to God. Glory to God. We are going to be given strategies for the end times. Because a great awakening has come. A great awakening has come. Yes. We're going to see weather misbehavior. Weather misbehavior. Some of the strangest patterns of weather will be seen across the globe. And when I say strange weather behavior, I'm talking on a global level now, not just in one part of the world. Globally. In all of the continents, people will be scratching their heads and wondering, we never saw this before. We got snow here. We got hail over there. What's going on? Write this one down as well. We're going to see miracles like never before. Signs, wonders, and miracles like never before. Like never before. The body of Christ on a global scale will be flowing in a new move of the miraculous. Let the miracles begin. The body universally will be flowing in the miraculous. Flowing in the miraculous. As God works through us, we will be the conduits through whom God flows. And some people will be shocked at who God will use. Oh, bless his name. Bless his name. More will be accomplished in less time with less people. More. God will do more in less time with less people. I remember watching a documentary of Michael Jackson, and he was 120 pounds. And they asked him, Michael, aren't you getting too thin? And he said, no, I am down to my dancing weight. In other words, when he was 120 pounds, that's when he could move with the kind of fluidity that he moved with when he danced. He knew what weight he had to be at to be at his peak when it was time to do all those tricky moves that he did when he was dancing. God will bring the church down to its dancing weight, trimming all the fat from everywhere, all of the gimmickry. One of the things that offends me in church is the extraordinary level of gimmicks that are done. And there's no much focus on sola scriptura, scripture only, solely on the scripture, that our faith would not be based on the wisdom of men, but the church is full of gimmicks now. It's like the hottest entertainment center with some of the most talented people. You can't argue with that. The greatest singing you hear is in church. That's why when the secular people want another voice, they scout the church. They attend church just to find the best singers and try to drop some checks in front of them that they had never seen before, and most of them can't handle it. Glory to God. We are going to see in 2023 the emergence of evangelists. The ministry of the evangelists will become like a highlight. All of a sudden you will hear of various evangelists across the world just popping up with powerful signs and wonders. Right now as I speak, they are feeling the stir. They're not listening to me right now. But in the realm of the spirit, they're feeling the stir. That fire is under them that's telling them, now is the time to go out and preach. Now is the time to rent those huge stadiums that can hold 100,000, 200,000 people. Places that used to have concerts with the big names the big name singers and entertainers are going to be the places that will be used by these evangelists, and they are going to be packed to capacity. Stadiums will be crammed like sardines with people who are hungry for God, because they have tasted of all that the world has to offer, and they are fed up with a life of sin. Some of you watching me, you're fed up with your life of sin. You're fed up with the wickedness. You're fed up with sleeping with everybody. You're fed up with... You don't even know what your life is about anymore. And you want a change, but a real change. You don't want to be a hypocrite. When I started going to church, I said to myself, I'm not going to be a hypocrite. I'm going to be the real deal, Holyfield. But across the world right now, and they have been hiding. They have not hidden themselves. God was hiding them to protect them from all the garbage that's happening in the church, so that when they emerge, they'll emerge pure and they don't have to answer to anybody. All of their ecclesiastical politics will not touch them, because they are not affiliated with this organization and that denomination. They're affiliated with the kingdom of God. Evangelists with signs, wonders, and miracles are emerging, and they will emerge all across the world, all across the globe. And guess what? Some of them will be children that God will use spontaneously. They will not be the featured name on the flyer, but in the midst of the service, the Lord will start using them. Children, 5, 6, 7 year old children. They will cast out demons with the wave of their hand. Not even say in the name of Jesus, with the wave of their hand. Oh, that can't happen. Watch it happen in front of you. They will cast out demons with a wave of their hand. They see a possessed person. The devil will know what they mean when they do that. That means get out of here. And they will go. Children will do that, Rev? Yes. Yes and yes. God will do more with less people. Let me give you one more before I get into prayer. We are going to have, this one will shock you, or not. We are going to have our political leaders across the globe call on the church to provide solutions for the nation's problems. The church will become a place of the answer and a place of solution to national problems, to national crisis. The church will become a place of solutions for national crisis. And the political leaders will call on them, the mayors, the governors, the prime ministers, the presidents, the kings will call on the church, because they will see and hear of the signs, wonders, and miracles. And we are not just going to be basing our growth on signs, wonders, and miracles. We got people with enough common sense and genius from God to answer and to be solutions to the problems of the nation. No longer will the church just be a place where you bury the dead and marry the wed. It will be a place of solutions that the secular world will come for. So prepare yourself in every facet of life, not only the spiritual aspect. If you have a gift and ability outside of church, hone that skill. God will use it. Are you feeling a brother? Amen and amen. All right, as you're sitting there, just lift your hands. And we're going to give the next 2 minutes to a time of worship. Begin to bless the Lord, who has comforted us on all sides, who has satisfied our mouths with good things, and who has brought us out of 2022 and is taking us out of 2022. And 2023, here we come. We are coming in hot. We are coming in hot. Remember, the month of January will be dedicated to the Lord. So all of your worship music, your good solid gospel preaching and teaching, get all those tapes out. And those who don't have any, look on YouTube. I promote Daniel Olokoya's prayer. He's got some half hour, 1 hour, 4 hour, 7 hour. Just pray along. When he prays, you say the same thing afterward. Just pray along with him, and it will not be boring because you have company. Pray his prayers until you find your own voice and find your own prayers. And then get some worship music. January month will not be the month of entertaining type music. you know, that kind of fast music where you dance and jig. We're not talking about that now. We're talking about reflection. We're talking about contemplation. We're talking about quietness. We're talking about be still and know that I am God. Some of you need to familiarize yourself with some of the hymns of the faith that you never sang because you came into the time, came into church at a time when we were singing spontaneous worship music, and the hymns and hymn books had been thrown in the garbage. Time to get them out, because some of those hymns are very powerful hymns of the faith. Bless the Lord. Tonight, I'm going to be praying specifically to dealing with the spirit of fear. Because whenever a new year begins, all kinds of nervous tension and apprehension, and people are scared out of their wits because they don't know what the future holds. That is why God gives insights into what the future holds so that you are not afraid. You're not afraid. God is preparing his people to be solutions to the questions that the world will ask. National leaders will ask. So God has a purpose for you. He has a use for you. You're not going anywhere. So stop being afraid. If he doesn't have you, there's nobody else for him to use. He's got to have you. He needs you. God needs you. The same way you need God, God needs you. Because without you, God has no voice. Without you, God has no hands. Without you, God has nobody to go to the hospital to visit the sick. Without you. So God needs you. The same way you need God. So don't be afraid. Don't let the devil tell you you're going to die. We shall live to declare the works of the Lord. Here we go in prayer. In the name of Jesus, I refuse to fear because God has not given me the spirit of fear, but a spirit of power, the spirit of love, and of a sound mind. I've got to find my microphone. I wasn't thinking about the microphone, but I just felt my helper come there and come so strong. Those kinds of anointings, I know them. Something nice is going to happen tonight. Yes, here we go. I refuse to fear because God has not given me the spirit of fear. I bind the spirit of fear in my life. I bind the spirit of fear in the work of my hands. I bind the spirit of fear in the atmosphere around me in the name of Jesus. I refuse to fear because God has not given me the spirit of fear. Every power that's financing and behind the activity of fear trying to come and operate in my life, those powers will receive the wrath of God and be consumed by it in the name of Jesus. Everything that I have feared, everything that I was afraid of, shall not come upon me, shall not come upon me, to the glory of God. Everything I was afraid of will not come to me, will not come near me. The local wickedness that I live around, I have been ever keen and afraid of, will not have a hold on me. The local wickedness, every community has their own wickedness. Say Happy New Year to Reverend Sheila Abraham. Good night to you, Minister Sheila Abraham. God bless you and Happy New Year to you. Glad you're on. Y'all greet her for me in Jesus' name. The evil that is obtainable in my family background, where the enemy thinks he has me cornered because he knows what the men of my family do, what the women of my family have done and do, and thinks he can get me because he got them, what caused them to fall will not cause me to fall. The evil everybody dreads in my family will not locate me, cannot find me. I have become invisible to that power. The failure and disappointment in marriage will not manifest in my marriage. The financial failure and embarrassment I have feared will not befall me in the name of Jesus. The fear of backsliding I have nursed and nurtured will not come upon me. The fear of not being spiritually fulfilled will not happen to me. The fear of being ministerially stunted will get out of my vision. I will grow and improve and become more. I will be a spiritual giant for God and not a pygmy. The fear of committing the unpardonable sin is washed out of me by the blood of Jesus. Let no fear be able to overcome me. I will not be overcome by fear, but I will overcome fear. Fear, you be afraid of me. You be afraid of me. Tell fear to be afraid of you. Fear, you be afraid of us. We ain't scared of you. You better be afraid of us because we are the army of the Lord. We are the kingdom of the Lord. We are more than conquerors and we are not afraid of the spirit of fear. We have the spirit of power, love, and a sound mind. Let the fear of missing the rapture go to the back of our mind and to the bottom of the pit. the fear of missing the rapture. A lot of people are afraid they will miss the rapture because the Lord will catch them doing something wrong. Why you want to be doing something wrong, number one? And why would God wait to catch you to leave you out? He sent his son to redeem us. He wants us in heaven. He's not willing that any should perish. So God is not waiting for you to mess up so he can call the rapture and leave you behind. He's trying to get you there. That's why the blood was shed, to make you clean enough to be able to... Come on, church. I bind and cast out every fear of compromising my faith. I bind and cast out every fear of losing my anointing and salvation. I break every evil covenant that has brought the spirit of fear into my life. And I command the terror by night that brings fear into my life to stop and get out of my environment. Get out of my environment. Every human agent using the spirit of fear to terrify me in the night shall stumble and fall. The fear of terror of the unbelievers shall not be my lot. My tomorrow is blessed in Christ Jesus. Therefore, you spirit responsible for fear of tomorrow, I bind you in the name of Jesus. My destiny is attached to God. Therefore, I decree I can never fail. I can never fail. I cannot fail. Failure is not my portion. Oh, bless the Lord. Oh, bless the Lord. Every bondage that I'm subjecting myself to by the spirit of fear, I break it off of me. All negative doors that the spirit of fear have opened in the past, I shut them. I shut the door of every negative door. I shut every negative door that the enemy, through the spirit of fear, has opened in my life. Hey. I will not get sick and die. I will not get stroke and die. In the name of Jesus, I will not get sick and be bedridden and die. That fear of sickness, that fear of infirmity, get out of my life. In the name of Jesus. My destiny is attached to God. Therefore, I decree that I will not fail. I will not fail. I shut the negative doors. Every disease oppressing and depressing that wants to come into my life, every disease that's oppressing and depressing me, making me feel like covering my head over the sheets, covering the sheets over my head, covering my head with the sheets and never coming out, just staying there for hours on end under the dark place. Glory to God. Every disease, every oppression, oh bless the Lord. I refuse to be intimidated by satanic nightmares. I refuse to be afraid of the dark. I refuse to be afraid of juju, voodoo, jambi, baku, spirits, poltergeists. I refuse to be afraid of them. And I say to them, you be afraid of me, because I'm a child of the living God. I know who I am in Christ. And he has given me power over all the powers of the enemy, that nothing shall by any means harm me. I shall not get in any accident. My children shall not die prematurely. No sickness will come and stay. Glory to God. Every enchantment and incantation of fear being made against me, I neutralize the power of fear. I neutralize the power of fear. I neutralize it. Every confederacy of the enemy in my home, in my bloodline, working against me, all arrangements of the devil concerning my home shall not stand. No satanic arrangement concerning my home shall stand. This house is dedicated to Jesus Christ and to the kingdom of God. And the devil cannot prevail here. This atmosphere is too hot for Satan to handle. Oh yes, I nullify every written, every agreement or covenant against my work. Everything that is written, everything that was agreed upon concerning my life and ministry, it shall be nullified. I remember when I came to Canada in the year 2000, three witches met me outside of a church. And one of them did the speaking and she said, let me say this to you. We know you're here to stay in this country to start churches, but you shall not start one church, and in 3 months you shall backslide and your ministry shall come to naught. I got so angry with that one that was speaking. I said, let me tell you something now that you have spoken. Tonight, when you come into the service here, you shall be on the carpet, moving like a snake, and you shall eat carpet tonight for your lunch. And people looking at me like, what are you telling her? I said, I told her she will eat carpet tonight. And they said, that's one of our singers in the choir. And she was with one of the other two witches. And that night in the height of the service, I called her up. And she wouldn't come. So I went to the side of the pew she was sitting on and I... The power of God hit her. And she fell to her right side. and crawl under the first pew, second pew, third pew, fourth pew, crawl to the front of the altar. And she was there rolling and tumbling and snaking. Snaking means moving like a snake on the carpet. That's what I call eating carpet. The carpet became her bed. And I did start the church after that. I started the church, I think it was a week or so after that. And 23 years have passed. Not 3 months. 23 years have passed. The devil is a lie. Don't let no witch put no word on you and you scare out of your wits. You talk back to that joker. David, talk back to Goliath. And who won? David won. Yes. I destroy all efforts of the enemy to frustrate my work. I nullify every writing, every agreement or covenant against my work. Lord, increase my greatness and comfort me on every side. Lord, increase my greatness and comfort me on every side. Let your favor come on me from the east, from the west, from the north, from the south. Let the spirit of favor, let the anointing for favor, let the blessing of favor, let the power of favor come into my life and stay. Let generational favor hit me like a tsunami. Yes. We know, Lord, that you delight in our prosperity. And we thank you for blessing us indeed in the work of our hands. Let no household enemy be able to control our well-being any longer. Anything that's controlling our well-being, we cancel it in the name of Jesus. Let all those who are against us without a cause in our place of work and in our place of ministry be brought to confusion. People who hate us for no reason, let them be brought to confusion. I close every door through which the enemy is working against me. No weapon of Satan and his agents that are fashioned against me shall prosper. None. My life is hid with Christ in God. Therefore, nobody can kill me or harm me in the name of Jesus. I open wide all doors leading to my blessing. I open wide all doors leading to my victory. I open wide all doors leading to my prosperity in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. No territorial spirit shall own territory while I'm there. They shall move when I get there. No territorial spirit working against us in our neighborhood shall be able to succeed. They shall be frustrated, they shall be bound, and they shall be cast out. Every demon trying to restrict our time, restrict our operation, restrict our ministry, restrict our access to building. We come against every demonic power that's trying to restrict our access to building, restrict our access to growth in our ministry, restrict our access to success, restrict our access to failure. Every demonic power that's planning and scheming and sucking their teeth and pronouncing evil wishes and negative words against us, we break their power in the name of Jesus. Their words have no value at all. We declare their words are invalid. We shall get married. We shall stay married. We shall have children and we shall bless the Lord. We shall buy property. We shall sell property. We shall grow to the right and to the left. Our stake shall be enlarged and our borders shall be increased in the name of Jesus. We shall have influence nationally. We shall have influence internationally. We shall have influence globally to the glory of God. We shall have property globally. We shall have property nationally. We shall have property internationally to the glory of God. Funds shall come in. Finances shall come in. Property shall be given to us. Buildings shall be handed to us. For the years that we have struggled, our eyes shall see the glory of the Lord. 2023 shall be a year of favor. 2023 shall be a year of favor. 2023 shall be a year of breakthrough. 2023 shall be a year of the miraculous. 2023 shall be a year of signs. 2023 shall be a year of wonders. 2023 shall be a year of fights and victories. We shall have victories. You can't have victory without a fight. That's why I said fights and victories. For we are more than conquerors to him that loved us. 2023 shall be a year of shalom. Shalom shall be a year of peace, to the honor, to the glory, to the praise of the Almighty God. We will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be upon our mouth. Our soul shall make our boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. For we sought the Lord, and he heard us, and has delivered us from all our fears. And so to all and sundry, I say, Happy New Year. Happy New You. To all and sundry, I say, may the favor of God run ahead of you. May the favor of God run alongside of you. May the favor of God be at the left hand, at the right hand, at the front, and at the back. May the favor of God be like a sheet that covers your head and like a blanket under your feet. May favor hit you like a freight train. May favor hit you like an 18-wheeler truck loaded down with steel and lead. May the blessings and anointings and favors and healings be upon your life and the lives of your children. May you receive generational favor in the name of Jesus. May the work of your hands find unusual, extraordinary success. May everything that you do prosper and explode to the point where you are shocked at how much the Lord has done for you. May you be blessed big time. May you be blessed God size. May you be blessed with a mountain of blessing. May you be blessed huge, huge, huge. May the Lord break the jinx from off of you. Break the hex from off of you. Break the spell from off of you. Break the curse from off of you. I break the hex from off of you. I break the vex from off of you. I break the jinx from off of you. I break the spell from off of you. I break the weakness from off of you. I break the terror from off of you. I break it. I break it. I break the susceptibility to the evil one coming and having a field day in your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I break it from off of you. I break the poverty from off of you. I break the lack from off of you. I break the insufficiency from off of you. I break it. I break it. I break it. I break the power that makes you invisible to the eyes of people. I break it from off of you. I declare that your glory shall be on exhibition. Your glory shall be evident. Your glory shall be seen. The real you, the glorious you, the powerful you, the strong you, the beautiful you, the good-looking you, the handsome you, the talented you, the gifted you, the genius you shall come forth, and people shall see you for the glorious child of God and the signs and wonders that the Lord has made you to be. Yes, that's what your reality shall be in 23. Glory to God. You shall be the cat's meow and the dog's bow wow. Yeah, you shall be the cow's moo also, to the glory of God. Yes, you will be all of that and a bag of chips and a Diet Coke with some cracked ice. The Lord is going to do things in your life that will make you laugh out loud. You know about LOL on Facebook. You're going to do it for real this time. You're going to do it for real because the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob will come forth to magnify himself through you. He will come and operate through you. Through you. Yes, you. You will be the conduit. You will be the place from which God flows. The place from which God anoints. The place from which God heals. Yes, you are favor. You are victory. You are blessing. You are joy. You are peace. You are the flow of God to the nations of the world. You are the flow of God to the bloodline of your family. You are the flow of God to the congregation that you attend. You are the flow of God to that workplace that you work at. You are the flow of God to that community that you live in. You are the flow of God to that high-rise complex, to that building that's by itself, and to the one that's connected to another. You are the flow of God where you work. You are the one that they call upon. You are the one that will see the signs, wonders, and miracles. You are the one that they'll just beckon for you to come and put your hands and touch them. Yes, you. They will see power jumping off of you. They will feel the presence of God when you pass. Your shadow will bring victory and healing to people in the name of Jesus. Oh, yes. Happened to me before. People stop me on the road and say, man, what is that thing that's coming off of you? There's a heat that's coming off of you. And I'm feeling like it's a therapeutic kind of heat. Are you a masseuse? Hey, if I tell you who I am, you wouldn't believe me. I would believe you. And when it's sinners, they do believe you. It's when it's the religious people. They don't believe a word you say. Yeah, right. Happy New Year, everybody. Love you. God's blessing and favor be upon your lives and the lives of your children. Kaburakasha. Yeah, let's join with Jimmy Swaggart and sing. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Then we'll go off in a minute. Yes, it's you. It's you. It's you. You're enough. You're sufficient for the cause. You don't have to add anything to yourself to be adequate for what God wants you to do. You're adequate now. You are sufficient now. You are enough now. Go on with your bad self. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Give it another minute. One more minute.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Happy New Year, Desiree Lane, Vonda Gaspar, Anita Pedro, Desiree Lane again, Mika Baptiste. How you doing, girl? Shanika Watson. Shaniki, how you doing? How is Barbados? How is the land of the flying fish? Precious Gem Francis. How is Antigua, Anguilla, Tortola, Monica Hudson? How is South America, Guyana, Highway, Anita Passard? How is New York, Bassanio Sicharan? How is Toronto, Canada? Who else coming up here? Vonda Gaspar, how is New York, New York? How is Queens, New York? Mika Baptiste, how is British Virgin Islands? Jillian Gonzalez, how is Guyana? Allison McKenzie, how is Port Drawing? Roxanne James, how is West End? Yes, I know my peeps, man. Say, brother, you know, you remember all those people? Yes. That's why the pandemic hit me so hard, because I know a lot of people. Father, surely the spirit of favor has come upon your people and is staying upon your people. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit remain with us all for 2023. May this be a year of extraordinary favor for every last one of us. May the man with the blessing in his hand run and chase us down. You are going to see people come behind you, touch you on the shoulder. The Lord just spoke to me to bless you with this. They'll come out of their homes at night and knock on your door. I can't sleep, the Lord said, to bring this blessing for you. Oh, it's not going to happen. It's going to happen to me, so it might as well happen to you. It must run down. The blessing must run down. The favor must run down. If it's happening to me, it must happen to you. Whatever happens to me must happen to you. When the oil was poured on Aaron, it ran down his beard. It ran down his skirt. It fell to the ground. Everything that came under Aaron's authority got the anointing. And when you're following a ministry, when you're saying amen to a live program, whatever is on that preacher is supposed to come on you. I will not rest until some of you receive that same kind of power from God. To blow and see action happen, healings happen, deliverance happen, demons cast out. People come under the power of God. Desiree Lane, if you believe me this year, you can become a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, a preacher of the word. And you will be one of those that will be a tidal wave, a hurricane, a force of nature. That's what I'm hearing. A force of nature. Yes, you, Desiree Lane. A force of nature for the kingdom of God. You're laughing and say, Rev, nah, man, not me. My mouth too hot. That's the mouth God wants to use. I got a hot mouth too. The saving grace of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest on you, remain on you, abide on you. To the glory of God in Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. I'm going to go now and toast with the Queen of Zamunda to a happy new year. If I got energy for God's work, I got to have energy for wifey too. Gloria a Dios, man. Yes. Let God arise and let favor be scattered on you all. Generational favor is yours. Say, I receive it. Generational favor is yours. Say, I receive it. Generational favor. Yours. Happy New Year, everybody. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you, be gracious unto you. The Lord grant you his shalom, shalom. Favor is yours all through 23. Amen.